Life is pretty sweet these days. A veteran
based Automobile Racing Club of America has crisscrossed this nation, showcasing the skills of some of the Midwest's finest stock car chauffeurs. Through the years, although the challenges have been steep, it was the vision of ARCA founder John Markham that this series would eventually reach the summit. That summit today brings into the ultra-modern Pikes Peak International Raceway to celebrate a landmark 1,000th series event. How truly appropriate that in the shadows of this majestic peak, long known for its ability to punish both man and machine, we would once again prepare to witness a personal triumph. Last week, Rod Millen mastered the mountain and captured these magic moments. Today, it is three-time and defending ARCA champion Tim Steele who must ascend the final step in what has been considered a remarkable comeback. This was the scene last November 5th at Atlanta Motor Speedway. A devastating driver's side impact with the wall. While testing a Winston Cup car, left Steele diagnosed with a closed head injury, double vision, and excruciating headaches. Suddenly, a promising career hung perilously in the balance. Many said he would never return, and even if he did, he would never win. Well, 4 weeks ago, he did return to Pocono Raceway, and he did win, silencing the naysayers with an impressive performance. Now, sources close to him say the only questions left to be answered are those within Tim himself. So let's ask him. Tim Steele, what do you have left to prove today, and could this be your final ARCA start?
You know, I just want to win today. We want to win, and you never say this is the last thing you're ever going to do. You know, it very well could be. There's a lot of things I have going on to Winston Cup, and you know, a lot of them stipulate they want me to just concentrate on Winston Cup, and once I get there, that's, you know, all I want to do is just put my effort towards the Winston Cup effort and go from there. You know, they keep you busy enough where you don't need to worry about racing any other times.
Well, Marty Reed, if he pulls it off today, his next goal will be to launch a NASCAR Winston Cup career, possibly as early as next week. But winning today could be easier said than done, considering the competition.
That's right, Jerry. We don't have to go very far. Just back to row number three. Take a look at the driver right behind me. This is Bobby Dotter. He's a former Busch Series winner. His dad won this series three times. Starting right alongside of him, it'll be Mark Gibson. He's second in the points. He has top five finishes so far this year, but he has yet to find victory lane. Let's move up into row number two. Gary Layton has three top tens to his credit this year, and he's looking for this race here at Pikes Peak International Raceway to be a breakthrough event for his team. Then, just right on the inside, it'll be Frank Kimmel. This is your current points leader. This guy has won 5 of the 9 races. He is definitely going to be a player. And on the outside of row number one, well, you've got Bill Baird. He won the pole back at Daytona. He has proven that he can go fast, but he is still looking for his first victory in 1998.
ESPN Speed World welcomes you to Pikes Peak International Raceway near Fountain, Colorado as we get set for the Pikes Peak ARCA 150 featuring the ARCA Bondo Marhide Series. It's the 10th race of the 1998 season, and going into this event, the point leader is Frank Kimmel by 280 over Mark Gibson. But as you take a look down through the top 10 in points, you can see that several positions are very closely contended. Well, hi, everyone. I'm Bob Jenkins, along with two-time ARCA champion Bill Venturini. A big night of racing here on ESPN2. After this ARCA race, we've got the open wheel cars from the USAC Midgets and Silver Crown Division for you. As Jerry mentioned, it's a special day for ARCA, their 1,000th race that they have sanctioned since 1953. It's their first venture into the state of Colorado. They have been in 25 different states, so, Bill, obviously the division is growing.
Sure. You mentioned Pikes Peak. The first thing that comes to mind, racing up a mountain on a dirt road. Today, we're at a beautiful one-mile paved oval, one of three new tracks that ARCA is going to go to this year. A new track. It's fun as a driver. It's fun to drive, and it becomes an equalizer. What I mean by that is nobody's been here to test. Nobody's got any experience to tell you what's happening. So it kind of becomes an equalizer, which should make for a very good, exciting race today.
Let's take a look at the starting lineup for today's race. As we told you, Tim Steele is on the pole for the event with a speed of 132.988. Bill Baird starts in second spot. In row number two, it's Frank Kimmel and Gary Layton. The third row, Mark Gibson and Bobby Dodder. Row number four, Mike Snow, flanked by Andy Belmont. The fifth row, Bobby Gerhart and Mike Schicchetti. Sixth row, Josh Baltus and Jeff Finley. Row number seven, Rich Woodland and Kevin Counselor. Row number eight, Dill Whittymore and Ricky Logan from Colorado Springs. The ninth row, Bob Howard, also a local driver, along with Kurt Piercy. The tenth row, Mark Boyd and Doug Keller. Row number 11, Alan Markovitz and Brian Kahns. The 12th row, David Boggs and Gary Clark. In row number 13, it's Norm Benning and Bob Strait. The 14th row, Joe Cooksey on the inside, Mark Brenner alongside. In the 15th row, it's Bo Carpenter and David Hall. Row number 16, Jim Lamoureux and Chuck Weber. The 17th row, Tim Mitchell and Drew White. Back in the 18th row, Randy Roush and James Hilton. And the final row is occupied by Alan Bigelow and Vic Walker. And we have several onboard cameras that will be helping us cover this race here this afternoon. This is Mike Snow, who will be in the Lucas Oil onboard camera. His car also sponsored by Lucas Oil. Frank Kimmel, the points leader, starts in the third position, carrying the Advance Auto Parts onboard camera. And Tim Steele, our pole sitter, has the ARCA Bondo Marhide onboard camera. Now, there is a story about Steele that could play into today's race. For that, here's Jerry Punch.
Well, thanks, Bob. One of the big concerns for Tim Steele is the fact that the fuel mileage may be a problem. You know, the Ernie Elliott motor has a lot of muscle, but a lot of muscle means it gets awfully thirsty. At Pocono, Pennsylvania, in his comeback race, they almost didn't make it because of having to make a pit stop. Now, they've changed carburetor, so they should be able to go to at least halfway and make it a one stop if we go green. But fuel could be a concern for him. Not a concern, though, for Bobby Gerhart, who can go at least 105, maybe 110 laps. But Marty Reed, still some concerns about other variables.
As far as tires are concerned, remember a couple of weeks ago the Busch Series was here. They were eating them up faster than the crews can eat hamburgers at a free picnic. But Hoosiers come here with a very strong tire. It can go the full fuel load. But remember, we had, as we go green, had a lot of racing out here with bias pipe. We'll see how slippery the track is, guys.
Green flag is out, and here we go. Bill Venturini, the pole sitter Tim Steele, has jumped out into a fairly sizable advantage here as they complete the first three quarters of a lap with the second place car of Bill Baird. Here they come around quarter number four for the completion of lap number one. It's all Tim Steele at this moment.
Earlier this week in practice, Tim Steele was definitely the fastest car with new tires, but it seemed like after about 15 laps, he seemed to back up just a little more than some of the top runners did. So, you know, we should see Tim be able to take off and run for a little while, and then hopefully everyone should be able to run right back up and catch him.
59 car of Mark Gibson just took away a position from the 74 of Gary Layton, so put Gibson in four spot and Layton back to fifth. The top five right now are Steele, Baird, Frank Kimmel, Gibson, and Layton, as the 65 car of Bobby Dodder runs in sixth position. It's good to see him back in the series.
Yeah, Bobby did a good job last week. He ran up to Milwaukee in his push race, finished 15th. One thing about Mark Gibson, he blew a motor in happy hour last night, and they've got a fresh engine in there, so I'm sure there's a little speculation on what's going on with him.
Well, the caution waves over Pikes Peak. We have a car up in the high side of the racetrack in turn number two, and we have a car spinning coming off of corner number four. That's the 25 of Bo Carpenter from San Antonio, Texas. That's in the high groove up and near the wall in turn number two. And the 19 car of Kevin Counselor spun coming off of corner number four. So all kinds of activity here on the third lap.
Yeah, you can see that car. He was hit. Looks like he was hit on the left side. I didn't quite see what had happened. And the right side of the car is damaged also.
And we had a couple of cars that were on pit road early also. The 57 of Mark Brenner is on pit road, as is the number six of Ricky Logan.
Yeah, that 25 car, the back of the wall car, Bo Carpenter. It looks like I may have a little work to do on that.
You're turning the wrenches on it, and by golly, when it crashes, you have to fix the damage also. So caution out here after lap number three of this 150-lap affair at Pikes Peak International Raceway. It's the ARCA Bondo Marhide Series. Tim Steele is leading with Bill Baird running in second position.
As a sponsor,
sponsor of the Fan Tour, the Money Store is offering a $500 cash rebate on home equity loans. It's the Money Store 500 rebate. It's a great way to get rid of bills and cut expenses. And now you can get an extra $500 cash when you get your loan from the Money Store. If you're a homeowner, call 1-800-LOAN-YES now and ask for the Money Store 500 rebate. But only if you call the Money Store.
Attention, citizens, if you plan to be on the road seeking fun and recreation this summer, here's an important tip. Nothing beats 1-800-COLLECT for staying in touch. It's easy to use and costs 10 cents a minute every evening. And as Mr. Chaz McFeely here learned, failure to use 1-800-COLLECT can get you in trouble. So there you have it. Dial 1-800-COLLECT. It's easy, you can save a bundle, and you'll keep our furry friends happy. 1-800-COLLECT. 10 cents a minute every evening.
Today, people who didn't send the money Western Union and the heartbreak it caused meet Sue and her boyfriend.
Ex-boyfriend,
Mike. What happened, Sue?
My car broke down. I called Mr. Wonderful here. Send money, I said.
And he didn't use Western Union.
No, and it took forever. I just spent hours with the tow truck guy.
Mm-hmm. Meet Sue's new fiancé, the tow truck guy, Lyle!
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
Mambo into Red Lobster and try our 30 shrimp dinner. Pick the two shrimp dishes that suit you. We pile on 30 shrimp for under 10 bucks. That's a lot of shrimp for just $9.99. The shrimp are jumping. So hurry in for your 30 shrimp dinner at Red Lobster. Because life on land is dry.
Welcome back to Pikes Peak International Raceway near Fountain, Colorado, south of Colorado Springs. The number 22 car of Alan Markovitz from Detroit, Michigan, spun and hit the wall over in turn number two. And, Bill, you can see the damage there to the left rear of the car. Let's see if we can determine what happened.
It looks like he just got out of the groove up in the gray stuff, and there's not enough rubber up there to keep traction and just kind of looped it.
And some heavy damage there to the left side of the car, but they're trying to repair it on pit road, so perhaps they can get him back into the race. Before we go green, let's get a comment from Marty Reed.
Well, quick add on Alan Markovitz. He had just taken Buck Baker's driving school, so when Buck sees this, he's not going to be real happy with his people because he forgot that lesson about not spinning.
Well, it's sometimes it's pretty easy when you're in the school, but it's a whole different story when you actually get in competition. We're on board with Bobby Gearhart, and Bill, he came in for a pit stop.
I don't know why. He's in the Kiwanden Casino car. He's been doing a good job all year for those people, running up front. I'm surprised he pitted. He must have had a problem because they're getting a green flag, and he's just coming out of turn two, and the leaders are coming across the start-finish line right now.
Green flag is waving, and we go back to competition on lap number 24 at the completion of lap 23. Still running the same up front there, your top four, as the number 59 of Mark Gibson is running in fourth spot behind Kimmel and Baird and Steele. Now Baird is staying right with Tim Steele as they race down the backstretch and head into turn number three. We switch to our onboard camera looking back from the leader Steele to the second place car of Baird.
If you remember at the beginning of the race, I said for about 15 laps, Tim Steele should be able to run away from everybody. But now we're, 25 laps into the race, and the four fast cars have been able to stay bumper to bumper now.
Yep, they are staying right with each other. Actually, the first three now break away from Mark Gibson a little bit, and then there's quite an interval back to the 74 car of Layton, which is running in fifth position.
Gary Layton's been quick all year. It just seems like he's leads the most laps, but he just can't get that first victory. Well, I should say that he won last year at Charlotte, but I mean, he should have won a couple races already this year, and he's run out of gas or he's been taken out by a slower car. But we'll see what happens today.
Gary, what was the situation with Bobby Gearhart?
Well, Bob, a tough break for Gearhart, who thought they could probably go at least 110 or 115 laps on fuel. They might have had him an eighth turn to a fuel mileage race, but the car is running hot, showing a lot of temperature inside the car, and that cannot be a good sign. Probably something up front in the engine.
We're watching him, however, move up through the traffic as he passes several cars on the backstretch, so that car is running fine right now, but maybe he will be plagued with this overheating problem as the day goes along.
Well, you know, earlier today they had run the Silver Crown cars, and they were on the bias ply tires, there's a lot of rubber on the racetrack right now, and that could be clogging up the grills on the front of the cars.
And you will see those races immediately following our coverage of the ARCA Bondo Marhide. Now, Frank Kimmel goes to the inside of Bill Baird as they run down into turn number one. Is he going to be able to get the position from him? They're still wheel-to-wheel coming out of two. Baird holds on for the moment.
You see Frank's definitely looking to the inside, but Bill's been quick coming off the corner. Right, like I said, right in the center, Frank's able to close it up. But as they come off the corner, Bill Baird seems to just pull him just a little bit.
We'll keep an eye on this race, Doc, but more information on Gerhardt.
Well, when Bobby called in a moment ago to talk to his brother Billy, who was the crew chief, they thought it might be something in the engine, but as Bill Venturini already predicted, what they did when they stopped was they cleaned off the screen in the front grille where a lot of the rubber from the USAC midget and silver ground cars that were practicing earlier today had gotten in the front of that car, and now, according to Bobby Gerhardt, the temperature is coming down, so maybe that was totally the problem.
We'll keep an eye on it, and they continue to run in the same order. Kimmel had a good run, it looked like, there for a while in turns three and four, but could not make a pass, and so they continue to run one, two, and three here with 28 laps now completed.
Yeah, the front three cars have hit, you know, got about a half a straight of a breakaway, but Tim Steele has not been able to shake Bill Baird or Frank Kimmel, which like it should make it really fun when we start to see pit stops.
Yep, he's of course a three-time ARCA champion. Tim Steele is winning in 93, 96, and 97, but he has not been able to defend his crown in 1997 because of the accident that we told you about earlier, practicing in a Winston Cup car at Atlanta. Now, once again, we see Bill Baird closing in on Tim Steele. We'll take a quick break and be right back with more from Pikes Peak International Raceway.
Perfect for the growing family. Four, possibly five bedrooms.
Affordable living at its best. This brick ranch features three bedrooms, two full baths.
This two-bedroom, one-and-a-half-bath ranch is a first-time buyer's dream.
Totally updated inside and out. New roof and siding. New kitchen with oak cabinets and hardwood.
This dream home features all the amenities of comfortable living. Call today.
The Real Estate Showcase on the Cable Marketplace. It's shopping made easy.
When I ran a courtroom, I was disturbed by the way the media put people on trial. Now I'm a journalist, but for a network that presents the facts and lets you be the judge.
See, this doesn't have much to do with sports. This was in an aquarium my dentist had, and the first time I got my teeth cleaned, I was waiting out there for like so long. I don't know what it is about some doctors. They just make you wait. That's my first introduction into that. That's why I don't really go to doctors anymore. But anyways, I was waiting, and I was just playing around with the fish. I just sort of clipped it. A little five-finger disc out. That's something I'm proud of.
Well, as you rejoin us here at Pikes Peak, we're under the third caution, and the onboard camera with Bobby Gerhardt says it all. The Kuwaitan casino car has developed some kind of a problem, probably an engine malfunction, and he has caused this third caution of the afternoon.
Yeah, that was probably brought on by overheating it because of if the radiator grill was clogged that much and he ran it that hot. Usually, a driver does not ever want to come into pits. So he'll stay out there till the engine's 250 degrees, and usually you end up causing a problem just like this.
Now, Marty Reed told us earlier that there was a caution between laps 40 and 50. We were going to see several pit stops. It's lap 51. Let's see if we have any of these front runners that are going to come in for a stop. It doesn't appear so.
Well, I haven't seen them wave the green flag to open pit road yet.
Ah, that could be it, yeah. The pace car has picked up the field, but the pace of the pit road still could be closed. Obviously, Bobby Gerhardt has made it to his pit, but he is experiencing quite a few problems here, and the hood goes up.
Yeah, that's a bad break for Bobby. He's been running so good. Like I said, the Kiwanis people are, I guess they've been real happy with everything he's been doing, and he's such a nice guy. I mean, I've known Bobby for years, and I'm glad to see him running as good and competitive as he has been this year.
Well, he's had three top 10 finishes. His best finish of the year was at Michigan, where he finished fourth. His
I think he was also on the pole there.
On the pole, yep. We televised that race. He finished sixth at Memphis, and he also finished eighth at the initial race of the season at Daytona. So it looks like that just about everybody on the lead lap is coming in for a stop. Tim Steele, Frank Kimmel, Bill Baird, all coming down for a stop, and Dr. Jerry Punch is awaiting the arrival of Tim Steele, who's pitted down toward the end of pit road, but he's headed your way, Doc.
Well, Bob, put it down in the books now. 53 laps are complete. There are just 97 to go, so they may be making their only stop if they get it full of fuel. They will change all four tires, and notice the right rear. That is Doug Schoenborn, who is lowering the track bar two rounds to try to tighten up Tim Steele. Left side tires going on the HS Dive Ford Taurus. Left side jack underneath the car, making sure they get it completely full of fuel. Now, fuel splashing back. Blood guts are on. Let's check in with Mark.
Well, Bobby Dodder, they took a turn and a half down on the left side and also put a little air pressure out. So they're obviously trying to get a little more fight there, guys.
12 cars on the lead lap and all of them pitted. And Bill Baird is going to be the one that suffered during this. He's going to drop back to fourth position. Kimmel has come out behind the leader, Tim Steele, and Mark Gibson got out in third. So we're going to have a jumble of the standings here as we get set to go back to caution, to a green. On board with Mike Snow now as he is awaiting his pit stop to be completed. He's pitted just across from us here in the main grandstand area. Now the car goes down on the jacks and away he goes.
I think the 26 car is one lap down.
Yes, he is a lap down. Jerry?
Updating the Bill Baird pit stop. You're looking at Eddie Sharp, who's the crew chief there, talking to some of the crew members. Apparently they had a lug nut fall off the left rear and they had to pick it up and put it back on. And that cost them an extra 4 or 5 seconds. They made an adjustment in the air pressure, trying to loosen it up. Remember I told you he had a push going into corners. Then we got on the throttle, the car would break loose. The push loose, Bill Pizzarini referred to. Well, they hope they fixed that, but what they didn't fix was a problem where they're mired back in the field now due to that lug nut problem and the extra 4.5 seconds on pit road.
Well, you know, he mentioned he made an air pressure adjustment. Air pressure adjustment will change one of those conditions, either the push getting into the loose coming off. But if you want to correct both of them, you actually got to do two things. You either have to make an air pressure adjustment and a track bar change or a wedge change. Now, what we've been seeing, everyone coming into pits, everybody's been making either a panner bar with, you know, adjustment or a wedge adjustment to tighten the cars up. So the track must really be slick out there and everyone's loose.
54 laps have been completed. We remain under caution here at Pikes Peak International Raceway. And so we'll take a break and be back with more. Andy Belmont now shown as the leader in the ARCA 150. Back with more right after these messages.
Rock and roll!
Is he up?
Eat less fat.
At Subway, you can get one of 7 sandwiches with 6 grams of fat or less. Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
Deciding on a truck? Get into these facts. The Mazda B2500 SE boasts aggressive new styling. The Nissan Frontier is, well, nice. The Mazda B2500 comes generously equipped with all these features for hundreds less than the Frontier. So, given these facts, we're pretty sure where you'll land. Right now, get $1,500 cash back or 0.9% APR financing. The new Mazda B2500 SE.
Don't miss a beat of the heart-pounding, heart-breaking action. Act now and watch over 100 Major League Soccer matches you can't see anywhere else. To order MLS ESPN Shootout, call DirecTV at 1-800-GET-SPORTS.
Are you old school?
I'm old school.
I'm old school.
I've always been old school.
He's sitting on 714.
Old school, like my shoes. Still cutting defense.
Like Magic.
Magic Johnson.
Old school, like Jackie Robinson.
Them pious.
But I might have been given a bad break.
Old school, like my father.
Lean, mean, mobile, agile, monster.
Choosing right to the door. Listen,
Dr. O'Day.
Five, slam a jam.
The original Afropunk.
Henry Aaron. That ball is out of here. It's
all right, dude. You want to be old school? Call a number.
The
ESPN Speed World coverage today at Pikes Peak International Raceway and the ARCA Bondo Marhide 150. We're under caution. Let's get a report from Jerry Punch.
Well, Bobby Gerhart was one of the pre-race favorites, and Bobby, it didn't last very long today. What put you out?
No, this is the first time we run this car, Jerry, and it's an inch and a half drop car that basically only has about 2 inches of frame clearance right underneath the front cross member. And it seems like something got up under the car and just stuck right in one of the oil feed lines. So it's just something that we can't fix right here.
You wanted to win this one for brother Tommy, who's recovering back in Pennsylvania. But not been a tough week for the Gerhart family.
Yeah, it's been a tough week. My younger brother Tom broke his neck playing professional football for the Canadian team, the Edmonton team. And Tommy, I hope you're feeling better.
All right, an emotional time for Bobby Gerhart, who wanted to win it for Tommy. Let's check in with Marty.
Well, since Tim Steele and Frank Kimmel kept true to their word and pitted right around lap 51 when we last went yellow, we should also finish off that conversation, because both guys explained to me that if they get the opportunity again around lap 100, they would do the same tactics. They would come in and get fresh tires, because as we pointed out earlier, around lap 50, they seem to drop off about 7/10 of a second, guys.
Okay, and we're getting the double file restart set up now as the field is about to get the green once again. It is Tim Steele still leading, with Kimmel running in second position, then Mark Gibson, Bill Baird running in fourth spot, and Josh Baltus in fifth. Jerry?
Let me update what Bobby Gerhart was talking about. His brother Tommy Gerhart plays for the Edmonton Eskimos for Coach K. Stevenson. Last Thursday night at Vancouver, he's a free safety. He was hit by one of his own players while making a tackle and broke his neck. They have flown him back to Pennsylvania. He is at home watching this race, pulling for brother Bobby, who wanted to win it, for Tommy to help him get better sooner. Back to green flag.
Indeed, and Steele moves ahead of the rest of the field. Kimmel giving chase in second position. We're on board now, looking back to the rest of the field. That's Frank Kimmel running in second spot. Tim Steele, as we look back to Kimmel and the rest.
It seems like right now everybody's just kind of sorting it out. Everyone's made pit stops. They've made some chassis changes. They put on some new tires. Everyone's car is starting to react a little different now, and they ran 50 laps. You know, you get in the rhythm of the car slipping and sliding. Now you got a car that you've made a chassis adjustment. You've got some fresh tires on it. The car is actually sticking better. You're running a half a second or three quarters of a second faster. And everyone's just kind of feeling it out right now. Tim Steele is definitely starting to pull away a little. But, like, you know, early in the race, he did that until 15, 20 laps on the tires. And it seemed like everyone seemed to be able to close up on his bumper, and we'll see what happens.
Number 18 car is driven by Josh Baltus, who's from Dayton, Ohio, only 23 years of age. And, of course, we know the Baltus name because of his grandfather, Earl, who owns Eldora Speedway in West Central Ohio. But Josh Baltus graduated from Ohio State University and has decided to at least spend the first part of his career driving race cars. He's currently seventh in the point standings, driving fifth here this afternoon and looking very, very good.
I'm really glad for the team. Josh, one of the nicest guys in the series. Young, articulate driver. Definitely running, I feel, one of his better races, and I'm glad to see it. I know they've got some new crew chief people involved with him, helping him this week, but, you know, Joe Slonkowski's been with him all year, and actually this is their second year, and I'm just glad to see Josh is really running this well.
And we get more from Dr. Jerry Punch.
And as Bill alluded to, remember Mark Thompson, the veteran ARCA painter who was injured earlier this year at Atlanta? Well, his co-crew chiefs, Bob Bissinger and Donnie Strait, have both come out and are helping Joe Slonkowski with the youngster, Josh Baltus. You see the result, running a solid top five. And by the way, speaking of Mark Thompson, who was diagnosed with a closed head injury in Atlanta earlier, we are hearing he is back full-time at work and planning his first race. Still as yet no date announced, but hoping to get back in a race car. And Bob, that is great news for Mark Thompson.
It sure is, because quite honestly, the ARCA division needs a driver like Mark Thompson in it. What a guy he is, and what a great race driver.
And I can attest to that, because I talked to Mark a couple of weeks ago, and he definitely sounded well. Didn't remember a lot of the crash, but, you know, a close head injury, the doctors had said that you usually don't. It's your own mechanism in your body that will help shut it out because of the pain and the injury. And I can attest to that. When I broke my neck, I don't remember what had happened until about a week later. But it's good to hear that Mark's back and back working, and hoping we can get back in a race car.
We're watching a battle here in involving the 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th place drivers, I believe. And they come to the line seeing cross flags. We are halfway through this event. The number 51 car that's leading there is driven by Joe Cooksey.
That's Dill Whittemore. Looks like the 56 car who's running sixth right now. Yep. Good run for Dill Whittemore.
Right behind him is the 51 of Joe Cooksey, and then behind him is Andy Belmont running the number 40 machine.
Dill Whittemore used to be Frank Kimmel's sponsor, and a couple of years ago he decided he wanted to get in the race car and drive it himself. He's doing a good job.
Let's take a break here at the just past the halfway point of this race. Tim Steele has been the dominant force so far, but still about 74 more laps to go before the checkered flag at Pikes Peak.
Sun is rising.
It's a great day for the comfort and convenience of changing tint transitions lenses. Indoors, they lighten. Outdoors, they darken. So lightweight plastic Transitions lenses are right in any light. Make the change to Transitions lenses and see for yourself.
It's a great day.
Transitions lenses, right in any light and right for you. ESPN Sunday Night Football. Season begins September 6.
We've gone yellow once again here in the ARCA Bondo Marhide 150 at Pikes Peak International Raceway. Andy Belmont backed his car into the wall up in turn number 2. Not a serious crash at all. He kept going, as a matter of fact. But now this caution has resulted in more pit stops. Jerry Steele is in.
Indeed, Bob, lap 82, Tim Steele comes down pit road. The reason being, there are only a dozen cars on the lead lap, and it's a why take a chance? We will need the fuel anyway. Now we definitely can make it the rest of the way on fuel. And on their first pit stop, they were showing 270 degrees in the right front tire. There's a lot of tire temperature, so why not come in and get some fresh rubber? Right side, now left side. They lower the track bar one more round to pick it up. Tim Steele is down and away as he goes by Frank Kimmel, who just comes off the jack, and now he will head back to turn one.
And I think Bobby Dotter was the guy that was really won the race out of the pits, because he was out well before either Steele or Kimmel or Gibson or anyone else. So I think he's going to be the leader here as we get set to go back to green.
Now, there are a couple cars that were on the lead lap that didn't pit on this segment. Mm-hmm. So even though Dotter was the first one out of the pits, he'll probably end up about fifth or sixth.
Yeah, there were 12 cars on the lead lap, and I think six of them came in, so we will have the other six that are at the front of the field as we go back to green in just a little bit.
And, you know, it's like a toss of the dice here or a flip of the coin. Should you have pitted then or shouldn't you? You know, Tim Steele, if Tim Steele's strategy is to finish the race without another pit stop, by far this was a smart move. But if he plans on pitting one more time, then you don't know.
Here's Andy Belmont, and the reason for the caution. This was up in turn 2. Looked like he might be able to keep it off the wall, but no.
No, but you got to remember, Andy didn't pit on the first.
That's right.
When all the leaders pitted on lap 50, Andy Belmont elected to stay on a racetrack. So he had, like, you know, 80-some laps or 80 laps on those tires, and that's probably why he just spun. You know, the track has been slick all day. We've been seeing that, and he was on tires that were definitely probably just had too many laps on it.
All right.
In the right corner of the picture, you can see there was a car on the outside of him, and it looked like he might have just clipped him with his right front. That's what could have spun him.
Okay, let's get out of Jerry Punch.
There may be a problem developing for Mark Gibson. You're looking at Mark Brenner, who is the driver who started their other car today. He's getting ready to put the helmet on. We are told that Gibson apparently is feeling sick on his stomach. Apparently, he's been sick this morning, a little bit of an intestinal flu, and getting sicker in the race car because of the heat. They called Brenner, who had already parked the backup car. He has now come running out to the pit road, and if they get an opportunity, maybe at this caution flag or the next flag, Brenner may get in the car for Mark Gibson, who is ill right now in the car, although he's having a great run so far. Let's go to Marty Reed.
Well, Doc, one of those drivers to stay out was Josh Baltus. He is feeling very comfortable. Talk to the team. They said the reason we want to leave him out is we're doing better on the long run. So it'll be interesting to see if the adjustments and all the changes and all the pit stops is going to play into the hands of Josh Baltus, because he's going to pick up some track position in this one.
You know, as far as Mark Gibson coming in and getting a relief driver, he's in the points chase for the championship for the year. He's going to really have to be sick to want to come out of that race car. But believe me, I know what it's like, and he's going to almost have to be passed out before they can pull him out of the race car.
Okay, let's give you the cars that did not pit. Bill Baird, Jeff Baltus, Josh Baltus, Dill Whittemore, Rich Woodland, Bob Strait, and Jeff Finley. All those cars were on the lead lap, did not come in for a stop, and so those are the ones up front as we get set to go back to green. And we will go back to green on lap number 86. Pace car has the field in tow, and corner number four makes the hard left off the track, and the green flag is waving once again. Tim Steele now is about sixth in line as they go seventh in line.
They go four wide going into turn one.
Ooh, and Bobby Dotter's
dropping back.
Yeah, gets shoved up high on the racetrack and loses some positions. Here is Tim Steele. We'll see how quickly he can move up through the field if he can. That's Jeff Finley, number 83, to his left as we're on board with Tim Steele. The 21 car is Bob Strait, and he passes him on the inside of the track.
He passed him with a little tire smoke coming off the fender. They rubbed fenders going down the straightaway.
So now Steele has moved up to fourth position at the moment. There is Josh Baltus just ahead of him, and now Tim Steele looks to the outside of Josh as they head through the third and fourth corners. Now steps down to the inside and will pass him also. So put Tim Steele in third place. The 56 car of Dill Whittemore is in second right now. Baird is a leader.
It sure doesn't take Tim Steele long to get through the field.
Just two starts for Tim Steele this year. He won at Pocono and finished second at Toledo. And he's closing in now on the 56 car of Whittemore. We talked about him earlier, but Dill used to be a promoter. He promoted some races in southern Indiana, North Vernon, for about a year, and then decided that that wasn't a great deal of fun, so he decided to get back into racing.
Dill's a really nice guy. I've known him for about 4 years now, and I'm glad to see him. He doesn't run all the races. He usually just runs the short track races, and even though this is a one-mile paved oval, you kind of bring your short track cars here, and or an intermediate car, and that's why Dill's here.
Back down to Jerry Punch.
We mentioned Whittemore is president and CEO of Indiana Steel Company. He had to go back and focus on the company this year. Only got to run a handful of events. He told me in the garage prior to the race that he will run the entire 1999 ARCA schedule. He has five brand new cars. Three he has bought from Sabco, Felix Sabatis, and two brand new Hutchinson Pagan cars he is having built for an assault on the whole tour next year.
How about that? All right, well, Dill Whittemore has dropped back to third because Tim Steele has passed him. Bill Baird is the leader of the race right now, but Steele is hot in pursuit. We'll take another break at the end of 89 laps here at Pikes Peak.
He's sold more records in Bulgaria than anyone. He's world famous in most non-English speaking countries. He's Yablo. And Windy Creek is proud to present his ocarina renditions of timeless romance classics. You'll cherish these much-loved melodies.
Hey, trust your own taste, not what somebody else tells you is popular. You can get a certificate for a free CD from an artist you choose if you win the Sprite Under the Cap game.
In the blink of an eye, this man will have to resist a basic human impulse. Could you? Don't slam on the brake. You could lose control completely. Hold on. Get off the gas. And gradually, pull off the road. Find more driving safety tips in this book. It's free from Shell. Count on Shell.
I am mushroom. I have faced the abyss.
I am pepperoni.
I have defied boundaries.
I am green peppers. I have ventured to the brink.
I am mouth-watering toppings that go right to the edge.
The Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut. Available in four delicious recipes. Chicken veggie, meat, the works, and a veggie loaded with a half pound of savory vegetables. Each with 16 pieces of succulent toppings. $8.99 is all you need to join them as they yell with one strong voice. I am the Edge Pizza. Hear me roar. Just one of the best pizzas under one roof.
I left my heart, and that's my song, and I've sung for kings and queens and seven American presidents. It's wonderful to have everybody recognize you. Will shine for me.
Beautiful, Mr. Bennett. But if you're going to write a check for these CDs, I still need to see some ID.
Use the Visa card that automatically deducts from your checking account at the millions of places Visa's accepted.
I left my ID in
San Francisco.
The Visa check card. Works like a check, only better.
Back at Pikes Peak, and we are again under caution, and this incident involved the number 22 car of Alan Markovitz. He was being lapped by both Bill Baird and Tim Steele and got up into the loose, Bill, and just lost it.
Well, I think, you know, you're running there, you're being lapped, you look in your mirror, all of a sudden these two fast cars are coming up on you. You go into the corner, all of a sudden they go past you like that, and you kind of... You lose your concentration. It looked like you just got up in the loose stuff and spun it and hit the wall.
Okay, well, Bill Baird does relinquish the lead, Jerry. He's coming down for a pit stop. You can see several other cars. In fact, almost the six that did not pit the previous time are now coming in this time. Jerry, Bill Baird is coming to you.
And, Bob, this will play into his hands. Remember, he has only pitted once today back on lap 53, and he wanted to be able to come in, get a caution flag, and put four fresh tires on his car, knowing that his tires will be at least 20 to 25 laps and Steele, Kimmel, and company who pitted earlier. That may be the break Bill Baird wanted. If we go green now to the completion, Baird will have the fresh rubber and may have his best shot at stealing his first ever ARCA victory. Left side rubber going on as the team here working. They had trouble with the left rear member on the first pit stop as they change the left side tires. Let's check in with Marty Reed.
Well, Josh Baltus, man, this crew did a heck of a job. They have got him four fresh tires, full load of fuel, and same situation, Jerry. This is a team that feels if this stays green, they've been doing better in the long runs.
This is going to be very interesting because, indeed, these cars have got fresh rubber now, and these guys that are up front that pitted earlier have quite a bit of distance on their tires. So we've got about 51 more laps of racing left here at Pikes Peak, and it could become very interesting in the ARCA Bondo Marhide 150. We'll be back with more racing in just a moment.
Wyandotte Shores Golf Course is Downriver's newest golfing gem. Located in downtown Wyandotte, on the scenic shores of the Detroit River, lies a very challenging and affordable course. Wyandotte Shores lets you make tee times up to 6 days in advance, so you can gather up your foursome. Tee times are available starting at 7 a.m. We also offer special senior and junior rates during the week. Come play Downriver's newest nine. Wyandotte Shores Golf Course. Call 246-4570.
These days, people think TV news is about as unbiased as the commercials. So if this commercial for a news channel makes you skeptical, good. Hang on to that feeling and use it when you watch the news.
He was on the lead lap battling for position. It's up in turn number two. He's okay, but unbelievably here with 13 laps to go, we're seeing those running up in the top four and five coming in for pit stops, including Tim Steele and Frank Kimmel. I can't believe this.
I don't understand it. We know Mark Gibson came in because he's feeling sick. They may do a driver change. I don't know. But I don't understand why Tim Steele and Frank Kimmel came in and pitted. And they're putting on four tires.
Jerry Punch.
I think they were trying to outguess each other. They figured if one of them pitted and the other one didn't, whoever came in with fresh rubber would probably win the race. And now they race off pit road, and Kimmel will win that battle as they have both put on four tires. By the way, Mark Gibson just came in a moment ago, did not make a driver change. They gave him some air and some water, and he's back on the racetrack. But looks like Kimmel is the freshest or the first of those three that pitted.
Well, this is a very peculiar situation. Of course, Steele and Kimmel have fresh tires now, and Mark Gibson, but boy, they've also got their work cut out for them in just a very few laps.
Yeah, Bill Baird's now leading the race.
Mm-hmm.
He was closing in on them, and now, you know, it's hard to say. What are there's how many cars on the lead lap? Nine cars on the lead lap, or they're going to have to go through the field now.
Let's take a look at what happened to Gary Layton. As I said, he was battling for position, and Dill Whittemore is right there behind him.
You can see Gary's in this slide. You're kind of scared. You don't know if you're going to really turn around or not. And then all of a sudden you get in the gray stuff, and sure enough, it snaps the car around. Yeah, it looks like they got into the corner, and Dill just touched him. It wasn't intentional. You can bet on that. But you know, when you're running 140 or 150 miles an hour into the corner, it doesn't take much to spin you around.
Marty Reed, Josh Baltus is making a pit stop.
Well, I guess it's sort of like monkey see, monkey do, and everybody else is going to go for fresh rubber. So Josh says, obviously, if I'm going to have a chance to win, I got to do the same thing. The only problem is he took one lap longer to come in and make this change, so he's going to be a little bit further back on the lead lap.
Well, he goes back out onto the racetrack. There's a 17 of Cicchetti also coming out after a pit stop. Well,
I don't know. I've been doing this 25 years, and I'm kind of confused on why everybody did what they've done so far.
I totally agree. They're the top five: Baird, Finley, Whittemore, Woodland, and Kimmel. Now, more on this from Jerry Punch.
Just spoke with Doug Schoenborn, who is the crew chief for Tim Steele, and basically Tim calls the race from the car. A lot of veteran drivers do that, and Tim said, I need tires. I'm skating all over the track out here. I need to come in. I'm concerned about the right front tire, which had shown some temperature. So he opted to pit. Frank Kimmel, who was following Tim Steele, said, if you're going to pit, I'm going to pit too. Why did Kimmel beating out? Because Kimmel only changed two right side tires. Why Steele changed four? But they don't have a lot of laps to get back to the front.
You are right about that. When they come down, they will complete lap number 140, so we'll have nine laps to go, and this should be fun.
Well, I remember, you know, I remember I was kind of my own crew chief, you know, when I was racing, and boy, my wife would really get mad at me when I tried to call the race from behind the steering wheel, and, you know, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. I'm not sure if it's the right move, but if Tim's as dominant as he has been in the past, it probably was a smart move, because you can see Kimmel was really starting to close up on his bumper, and he felt probably there were 15 laps to go that Kimmel was eventually going to get him anyhow. And the only person that can tell that is Tim Steele.
That's right. There are 10 cars on the lead lap as we get set to go back to racing. Baird is at the front of the field. Tim Steele is going to be back in sixth position. Gibson, seventh. The 21 car of straight is in eighth. Boss Josh Baltus is in ninth. And Bobby Dotter is in 10th position. Those cars on the lead lap. And here we go for the last nine laps of the race. And Baird gets a pretty doggone good jump as the green flag comes out. He pulls away from Finley and the others. We'll watch Tim Steele. There he is at the top of the race. That's Rich Woodland that he is trying to pass way up high on the racetrack. There's Kimmel down beside him. Oh, it's three wide heading for turn three. Something's got to give here.
Look at these two guys. They're going around now inside and the outside of everybody.
Unbelievable traffic there in turn number three, but everybody made it through. Tim Steele is in second position now and charging toward Bill Baird.
Well, he's only got one more car to prove that he made the right pit strategy call.
Yeah, he's quite a bit ahead, but Tim may be able to run him down here now in the final laps. There's the interval between first and second position. Bill Baird completes lap number 142.
There's only eight laps. Tim's definitely a lot faster on new tires, but I don't know if there's enough for him to be able to catch Bill Baird.
Finley and Woodland
there battling side by side as the contest for position continue.
That 86 car, Rich Woodland, he won the West race back in March in Phoenix, and I'm kind of pulling a little for him. He runs out of my shop on Concord.
Baird completes another lap, but the interval back to second position is much less this time than it was last lap. Tim Steele running down Bill Baird here. Frank Kimmel in third position, and he also is closing in on Baird. So who is it going to be in victory lane here this afternoon? We'll take a break and be back to show you what happens in the closing laps here at Pikes Peak International Raceway.
Rich Crystal Big Prints. What a difference.
Crystal color, contrast, clarity.
The photos of the future.
Plus a Ritz Blitz Extra, a bonus enlargement or album with every roll developed.
Say cheese with Ritz.
Tonight only, you can call anyone in America absolutely free just by dialing 1010-321, then 1 and the number you want to call. You see, 10321 has changed to 1010-321, and we want to show you how easy it is to use. So just dial 1010-321 tonight and talk up to 20 minutes absolutely free. It's so easy. 1010-321 saves 50% on all calls over 20 minutes every day. But try it tonight between 5 p.m. and midnight and get a free 20-minute call.
Rock and roll!
Is he up?
Eat less fat.
At Subway, you can get one of 7 sandwiches with 6 grams of fat or less. Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
Some called it the fight of the year. Carl Thompson beat Chris Eubank for the WBO Junior Heavyweight Championship. Now they meet again. Watch Friday at 8 for their original bout, then tune in Saturday at 5 for the rematch. Live from Sheffield, England, only on ESPN2.
Back at Pikes Peak, Tim Steele gets a good run off the second corner. We're on lap 146, and he goes to the inside and passes Baird, and Steele gets the lead, so his strategy plays out.
You know, like I said, the only person that can really tell on that is the driver, Tim Steele. And Frank Kimmel, who also came in and put on new tires, is closing in on Bill Baird also.
And we've got less than 4 laps to go, Jerry.
We told you at the top of the show, Bob, this might be Tim Steele's final start in an ARCA car. If he could pull it off here, the comeback would be considered complete. And I'm now being told he will test at Indianapolis Motor Speedway next week with Bud Moore, and that Bud has hired brand new crew chief Joey Knuckles, a veteran from the former Robert Yates team years ago, who will be with that car. They may run Steele at Pocono in the Winston Cup event coming up in a week or so in July, and maybe 4 other events for a total of 5 in the remainder of 1998. What a comeback for Tim Steele.
We just have 3 more laps to go now, and Steele has the advantage. Really looks like maybe the best battle is going to be between Kimmel and Baird for second. There is Frank moving in on him. They come down and get the complete lap 148, so we got 2 more to go. Let's watch the Kimmel and the Baird battle. We're on board with Frank. And he has a good run, it looks like, coming off the corner.
Yep.
Down the backstretch they go, but Kimmel will make no move this time.
Well, he had to back off a little. There was a lap car right in the center of the corner. And Frank, like we had noticed earlier today, is really quick right in the center down on the bottom. 1 lap to go. We'll see if Frank can get him going into 1.
White flag is out. Tim Steele within a lap of winning his second race of 1998 in the ARCA Bondo Barhide Series. Who will win the battle for second? Once again, Kimmel looks to the inside of Baird as they come out of corner number 2. But Bill has some speed down the straightaway. If he can prevent Kimmel from getting a good run here, he's going to be able to finish in second position. Off the fourth corner comes Tim Steele. He wins, and Bill Baird finishes second. Frank Kimmel finishes in third position. And a good battle between Dill Whittemore and Rich Woodland, and I believe that Whittemore finished in fourth position.
Yeah, it looks like Dill crossed the line maybe about 2 feet ahead of Rich Woodland. But a good race for all 5 guys. Good race up in the lead between Bill Baird and Tim Steele. He made the right call. I mean, when I saw him come in, I didn't know, but, you know, he made the right call.
Yeah, you got to really question what he was doing at that time, but sure paid off for him, and Tim Steele drives to victory lane again. He is the all-time super speedway winner in the ARCA Bonneau Mohawk Series with 18 and 31 total career ARCA wins. Make that 32. He is tied for fourth on the all-time list. He had 12 wins in 1997, records his second in three starts in 1998. Tim is from Coopersville, Michigan, and it's good to see him back from those injuries. And Jerry told you about his Winston Cup hopes, and let's hope that things turn out well.
What a credit to Tim and his family and his team. I know what it's like, you know, you have an injury to come back and get in a race car. It took me 6 months to get back into the swing of things. It took Tim Steele one race. I mean, this is his third race. He's finished, what, two firsts and a second out of his first three races back. That's a credit to him that, you know, he's probably one of the best, I feel, one of the best drivers to come out of ARCA there is today.
And it will be interesting to see how he fares with that ride in the Winston Cup Series. So Tim Steele drives to victory here at Pikes Peak International Raceway in the ARCA Bonneau Mohawk Series. There are the top five unofficial results. We'll be back to talk with Tim in a moment.
Deciding on a truck? Get into these facts. The Mazda B2500 SE boasts aggressive new styling. The Nissan Frontier is, well, nice. The Mazda B2500 comes generously equipped with all these features for hundreds less than the Frontier. So, given these facts, we're pretty sure where you'll land. Right now, get $1,500 cash back or 0.9% APR financing. The new Mazda B2500 SE.
Today, people who didn't send the money Western Union and the heartbreak it caused. You say your dog called?
Yeah, said he needed tuition money for obedience school.
That's amazing.
No, he's always asking for money for something. Hey, Madonna.
What did you do?
I sent it.
But not Western Union?
No. They never treated me special.
So it never got there?
No. But that's not the worst part.
It's not?
No. Now he turned the cat against me.
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
All weekend long, all kinds of racing. The race is on ESPN2. If it goes fast and looks cool, the race is on ESPN2.
Oh, how sweet victory is. And Tim Steele has driven to victory here in the Pikes Peak ARCA 150 at Pikes Peak International. We go down to victory lane. Here's Dr. Jerry Punch.
Well, Bob, they are all smiles in victory lane. What a comeback. Tim Steele, congratulations on win number two in just three starts.
Thank you, Jerry. You know, I think if anybody had any doubts that if I was better or not, I think maybe this last little shootout might have showed everybody because, I don't know, I think at one time I was at least five wide, it felt like, anyways. And you know, got through the traffic good, and guys done a super job in the pits all day. You know, it's HS Dye Softec crew. They've been working real hard for me. It's just, this is a great deal. You know, maybe this will be a way to leave the ARCA Series with a win.
Well, you talked about this being your last start possibly. I got to ask you first, though. The guy said you made the call to come in with just a few laps to go and put tires on, and one guy turns and, you know, he did hit his head a few months ago, but, hey, you proved you were right.
Yeah, you know, you always feel better when you have fresh tires, you know, and somebody else is going to, the other guys would have put fresh tires on. We would have got beat by tires, and, you know, Bill Baird got beat by tires today. And it was just, you know, we, in a deal like that, you need four tires, especially when there's only, you know, 8 or 10 cars on the lead lap. And thank God it wasn't a 200 lapper, because on that last restart, I think I broke a valve spring, picked up a miss there at the end.
You made a gallant effort to be able to pass Bill Baird with just a couple laps to go. I mean, tell us about that.
You know, I was just watching what he was doing. You know, I was reeling him in and catching him, and was just, you know, I had it figured out where I was going to catch him about three laps before I did. And it's nice that plan all came together. I had that plan, you know, figured out. It's like I could see where he was slipping a little bit, and I knew where I could get, you know, where he got, where he couldn't get it didn't look like, or I didn't see him go down there, and he just, you know, I was planning ahead.
Well, Tim Steele, congratulations. He wins what may be his final ARCA start and is on his way, Bob, maybe to a bright NASCAR Winston Cup future.
And congratulations to Tim and all the crew. Let's take a look at the unofficial results here. And we've got just a few more seconds on the air. So while you read through those final standings, Bill Venturini, thanks for your help. Good job. It's a good race, too.
Thanks. I'm glad. I'm sure a lot of these guys are glad to see that Top Tech Taurus to leave this ARCA series.
Stay tuned. Larry Rice and I and Marty are coming up with the Midgets and Silver Crown. And don't forget the No Fear Challenge Saturday at 4 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN, the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. And the 4 o'clock on Sunday, the Busch Series Grand National Division Kenwood 300. Again, congratulations to Tim Steele. For Marty Reed, Jerry Bunch, and Bill Venturini, I'm Bob Jenkins. Thanks for joining us.